Hello, boys and girls. Today we are going to switch math up a little bit. Instead of talking about time, we are going to talk about a way to measure. So today we are going to use standard units to estimate liquid volume. So when I say liquid volume, I mean liquid, water, right? Pretend we're talking about water, volume, how much water is going to fill something up. So metric capacity is what we're going to be talking about today. So the word capacity is something you may have never heard before, but you are definitely familiar with it. Capacity or liquid volume, what I was just saying, is the amount a container can hold measured in liquid units, okay? So any container, how much liquid can fill that container? So if you look right here at this Dr. Pepper container, that's a container. How much soda is going to go inside of it? If you measure the amount of soda that can fit inside of it, that's the capacity of the container. This bowl of cereal, how much milk can go inside of it? How much milk can this bowl hold? That's its liquid capacity. How much milk it can hold? How much milk can go into this cup? How much water can go into a tub? How much tea or coffee can go into a teacup? How much milk can go into a carton of milk that you would buy from the store? Maybe even how much soup can fill a soup can, okay? These are all containers that can hold liquid, and we're talking about how much liquid can they hold. So when we're talking about how much liquid they can hold, we use two different measurements, two metric units of capacity. They are milliliters, which is right here, or liters, which is like a water bottle. So you can see it a bit more. Okay, so a milliliter is about 20 drops from an eyedropper. This is an eyedropper right here, 20 drops from an eyedropper. Think about an eyedropper. Have you ever gotten an eyedrop in your eye, right? Maybe from the doctor, maybe from the nurse, maybe from your parents, okay? Or maybe you can just remember getting medicine once in a little eyedropper where you get a very small amount of it. Okay, that's an eyedropper. It's such a small, small, tiny little amount. So 1 milliliter is about 20 drops from an eyedropper. It's very small, super small. But 1 liter is like a water bottle. Think of a big water bottle, right? A nice big water bottle. That's about a liter. Okay, it's a lot of liquid. Okay, so the way these are compared is 1,000 milliliters, 1,000 of those equals 1 of those. So you would have to sit there and drop out tons and tons of little drops of water to fill up a water bottle, okay? Because of 1,000 milliliters is equal to 1 liter. So this is very, very small amount, and this is a very, very big amount, okay? So today what we're going to be talking about is figuring out which would we use to measure different objects. So you have to think about an object and think, are we going to measure it using milliliters, a super small amount, or liters, a big amount? Could we use it using multiple or at least 1 water bottle, right? So think, let's start with a toilet. How much water is in a toilet, right? In a toilet bowl. Do you think we would sit and fill it up with a little eyedropper? That wouldn't be very smart, right? That would take a really long time. So we know that it would probably be a couple liters would fill a toilet bowl. All right, now let's think about this little medicine container. Do you think I could take my water bottle and fill up, dump the whole thing into a medicine container? I don't think so. I think it would definitely overflow. That would be too much. So 1 liter would be too much for that, so that would be measured in milliliters. What about a tub? We talked about a tub before. Were we going to use an eyedropper to fill up a tub? No way, that would take forever, right? So that's definitely liters. Same with a sink, right? If you go into your sink in your kitchen and you wanted to fill it up with an eyedropper, that would take a long time. So this would definitely be filled with liters. What about this little ladle? It's a spoon, okay? Do you think that I could take an entire water bottle and fill it into like a big ladle that you use for to get soup. It's too small, right? That would be way too much liquid. I'm going to quickly sort some of these out. I know that a soup bowl is pretty small, right? My water bottle would put way too much water in there and it would probably overflow. So I'm going to measure that one in milliliters. I would say the same with a can of soup. I mean, a can of soda. That's also pretty small. My water bottle would def is definitely bigger than that. A teacup? I would say a teacup is similar to a can of soda. So that would be measured in milliliters. This big container of gasoline, I think that is a lot of, there's a lot of liquid inside of that container, and it's way more, way bigger than one of these water bottles. So I'm going to say that that would be measured using liters. I would say a big container, if I were making, having a lemonade stand and I were making a big container of lemonade, I think that I would be making a lot of it and it would probably be measured in liters. Same with a tea kettle. Now the rest, I think they're all pretty small, so I'm going to measure them all in milliliters because they're all small, pretty small objects, and I don't think that a giant water bottle would be able to fill them. I think it would overflow. So those would all be measured in milliliters. Okay, so after we have decided which one would be, if it would be measured in milliliters or liters, now we're going to talk about which one is a better measurement for each. So let's look at this one. A water in a fish tank. Is it 50 milliliters or 5 liters? Think about 50 liters, 50 milliliters. We're using an eyedropper, right? That's way too small. Even using a little eyedropper, we would never be able to fill a giant fish tank, enough for fish to live in, right? So that one would definitely be 5 liters. Let's see if we're correct. Yes, we were. Awesome. A perfume in a bottle. Interesting. Would it be 250 milliliters? 250 drops from an eyedropper or 25 liters? I know that when I spray my perfume on, it's definitely smaller than a water bottle. So would it make sense that it's 25 of these? I don't think so. 250 seems like a lot, but it's definitely not 25 liters. So it must be 250 milliliters. Yes, we are correct. Ooh, gasoline in a gas tank. Gasoline in a gas tank. 5 milliliters? I'm already gonna say there's no way that I would fill that up with 5 drops from an eyedropper, right? So it has to be 5 liters. Yes. Then food in a crock pot. I know a crock pot is pretty big and it can feed a lot of people, right? If I have a soup in a crock pot, it can definitely feed my whole family. So would it be 10 milliliters? 10 drops from an eyedropper? No way. That's way too small, right? It must be 10 liters. Good. And then the last one is a medicine in a spoon. 2 milliliters or 2 liters? Medicine? Could you imagine when mom says it's time to take medicine, you have to drink 2 full of these? That's way too much. So it can't be 2 liters. It has to be 2 milliliters. And we are correct. Awesome. Okay, so now you have to not only know what a milliliter and a liter is, but you have to be able to compare the two. So if there's 1,000 milliliters in 1 liter, we have to think about if 1,000 milliliters is 1 liter, then what's 2,000 milliliters? That would equal 2 liters, right? 1,000 plus 1,000 equals 2,000. You look at this number right here, right? One. And then 3 zeros, multiply it by 2, just like when we're multiplying by 10, right? The zeros don't change. So in 1,000 milliliters, we would have 1 liter. Now in 2,000 milliliters, we would have 2 liters, right? What about in 5,000 milliliters? Just the same. Right? 1, 2, 3 zeros, 1, 2, 3 zeros, 1, 2, 3 zeros. It's the same. Now here we have 7,000 milliliters, 1, 2, 3 zeros, and we must have 7 liters, okay? You can use addition to help you. We have 1,000 plus 1,000 If we added those together, we would get 2,000, right? 0, 0, 0, which is what we have over here. We did 1 liter plus 1 liter equals 2 liters. Okay, it would work the same. So if you wanted to use addition, you can, or you can use multiplication too. Now, if we flipped it the other way around, we know that 2 liters equals 2,000 milliliters. 5 liters equals 5,000 milliliters. 7 liters equals 7,000 milliliters. We're just flipping it around. 3 liters must be 3,000 milliliters, right? For every liter, we have 1,000 milliliters. If we have 3 liters, 1,000, 1,000, 1,000, add them all up together. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000. Same with 4 liters. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, right? You're just switching the number of milliliters to 1,000. And then this one down here says 9 liters. Sorry, it's hard to see. We would have 9 liters is equal to 9,000 milliliters. Okay, so now you know the difference between liters and milliliters, right? They're used to measure metric capacity, right? How much liquid can an item hold? So you're going to use this information and you are going to go on to Pearson and try some problems on your own.